to the decks. Okay, so Veslar, you slashed said pirate right here. Let's put a wound marker on him. There, have a wound marker, pirate.
Thank you.
All right. And I have to roll for this captain over here. The other captain from the other ship. Oh, yes. Go for it, captain. Okay, he has dispatched this pirate right here.
Nice.
All right, it is now back to Piper. And it's your turn.
So did you guys take a break, or what happened?
We took our break, yes.
Oh, perfect. Okay, so we're still in.
We
went ahead and took
you.
A break.
It was all alone.
And we left Shaggett to hold down the fort. I don't even know what chat was told.
He had one job.
I only ever talked to like 15 people at a time. It was 100, over 100 now. It's scary.
The odds are chat probably said something along the lines of, you know, ask him a few questions. And as far as chat's concerned now, we're probably streaming every day. Who knows what he told him, so.
Okay, so I'm a little flustered. Literally, I ran like...
Oh, you're good.
Through buildings and downstairs and... Okay, so...
You and Arya are locked in combat with... Captain Flores, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And it is
so,
your turn.
Okay, so I'm going to do something weird here. So I've got my longsword in my hand.
Yep.
So here's what I'm going to do. I am so mad. I am dropping my sword, and I am running with intent of pushing his ass overboard. Yes.
Okay, that smells like a grapple check to me.
Ho, ho, ho.
I don't know if it's a good idea, but it's what I'm doing.
You know what? Sometimes good ideas are bad ideas, but at the end of the day, it will be fun. Let's make a grapple check. Oh, an 11. An 18.
Not bad.
All right, because this is such a monumental moment, I'm going to roll this openly. Slash R.
What does he need?
1d. Well, it's his grapple versus yours.
Okay.
1d20 plus 2. Actually, I've got to add his base attack as well, so 20 plus... plus 7. Actually, he's tied with you. Okay, here we go.
No!
Can I have one?
What?
Natural 20!
Okay, you lunge forward at Captain Smarty Pants. As you do so, his pirate-like reflexes kick in. He sidesteps, grabbing you by the back of the jacket and spins you. You need to make a dexterity check or you're going overboard.
Wow. All
right, dex.
It was an awesome attempt, though. It was awesome.
Now, is that a reflex dex?
Basically, dexterity plus your dex modifier. So you're going to make a d20 plus your dex bonus.
Okay, so not the saving throw.
No.
14.
Okay. Basically, you lunge forward, he sidesteps, grabs you, and hurls you at the last moment.
Oh.
So here's you right now.
Are you being dangled, or are you in the water?
No, she's not in the water. Basically, her legs go over, but she's like... grabs hold of the top. Your long sword is either in the drink or laying on the deck. With C slash R.
Oh, she threw her long sword on the ground.
I did.
Oh, actually, no, you did. So it is on the deck. Good deal. And your two-handed sword is over your back. So you're basically hanging on to the edge of the ship right now.
Oh my gosh. So
it was
not...
a valiant attempt, and I commend
he's
you.
He's not
the
touching
attempt.
Her at all. He's holding.
No.
Sorry.
He, like, just spun around. I mean, what you basically saw, she dived at him. He deftly spun around, grabbed hold of her back, and was like, and you saw her fly over. At the last minute, her strong military arms grabbed hold and clung to the edge, which stops her hitting the water. But he's got a hearty grin on his face, like, ha, ha, ha. And now it's you and him.
Oh my gosh.
Which is always what a bard wants to hear. And it is his attack. Unfortunately, he lashes now full attack. The first He lunges forward with his cutlass, attempting to stab your Peter Pan-type-esque form, but you nimbly dance your way to the left. He then comes flinging back with his cutlass, and you're now, your armor class, you're wearing leather, right?
Yeah.
Okay, as you attempt to duck the blow, the top of the cutlass just nicks your shoulder for 4 points of damage.
Alright.
Alrighty.
You guys gonna need some help up there, aren't you?
Aria!
Alright, here's what I'm doing.
It is... Actually, it's the enemy pirates. Oh, okay. Let me roll for them first. Okay. Now it's your turn, Aria. Go for it!
Alright, I'm gonna back up and just start screaming, Veslar! Veslar!
Okay, he is pressing you down the stairs, so he's following you, basically, hacking away as he does so. It is now Arya's turn, and you're backing away. You're not doing anything physical?
How far can she go, Jesus?
I don't know. I'm just walking and yelling your name.
Right, your pirates are, or I say your pirates, the pirates are losing.
Good, yes.
Okay, it is now Vestlar's turn.
Well, okay, so is Aria there? Because she kind of ran like
yeah,
all the
I'm
way
yelling
down.
Your name.
G-Dace, what's up, buddy? Good to see you, man.
All right, I'm going to head and kind of shove you out of the way. I'm going to shove you over here so I can engage the dude.
Okay, and so you sling. You basically slinging herself to the side.
Fucking bards. And I'm going to do a regular attack, just a normal hoopty doop. no.
Hooply poop, you say?
Okay, you lunge forward. 14, no. You're hacking at the captain, right?
Yeah.
No, you missed. Okay. Yeah. Let me roll for the other captain. Alright, the first mate has just been hacked down. He's dead too. Let me knock him off. Alright. Well, the sailors from the... I never mentioned the name of the ship that you're going toe-to-toe with, did I?
No.
Okay, so the ship that you're up against, the other ship is called the Fleeing Mayweather.
Interesting.
Interesting, right? So, the Good Fleeing name. Mayweather.
Fleeing
All
Mayweather.
Right. Fight fans, get the reference. Okay, Piper, it is your turn. Fortunately, your good sister Aria distracted his captainness, so no one is there stamping on your fingertips
they get it.
Or trying
they
to
get
push
it.
You in.
Yeah, they get it. They totally
they get it.
This.
They get it before
Booyah!
You even said. They laughed the second it went on stream.
10 points for Gryffindor.
There you go.
All right, that's it.
So I will
Fanny Manny, thanks for the follow.
Climb back in the boat.
Okie dokie, you're gonna pull yourself back up this turn. Okay.
That'd be great.
And there you are. You're back on board. Arr. Shickles the pirate. Okay, okay, Captain X is the captain, he is fighting Veslar. So it is Veslar has intervened between himself and young Aria. Veslar, what is your AC, please?
It is a beautiful 20.
Okay, he slashes low and wild with his scimitar. You basically sprawl your legs backwards as the cut, like, pretty much misses you by about 3 inches. Then after that, he comes down with a wild overhead swing, which your bastard sword very easily parries to the side. He's clearly overcompensating for something. Okay, it is now... Let me roll for the enemies there. Aria, it is your turn.
Cool. Is it a lot to jump up here? Is it a pretty high?
You would have to make a successful jump of 15 or higher to jump. You can't jump, like, spring up there. You could jump up and grab and pull yourself up with a successful 15.
Or one move. I basically want to get over here. So can I make it
you
that
can
far?
Flee... Around and up the stairs, yep.
Yeah, I'll just do that.
Okay.
Okay, Okay.
Let me roll for our sailors. Ooh. Sailor is not doing so well this time.
And can I do an action, or is that the whole thing?
That would be your whole thing to get that far.
All right. Gotcha.
All right. And it's back to Veslar.
I'm going to do as hard. I'm going to go in as hard as I possibly can.
Wild, crazy swing.
Yeah, it's not, it wouldn't happen even if I rolled well.
Nope. Okay, you lunged.
He's on the stairs. It's
violently
like,
at yeah. Captain Flores, but you missed. He very deftly just clang, parries your sword to the left as he's like, ha ha ha, looking at you like you're some young fop. I've had better cabin boys than you. Okay, Piper, it's your turn.
All right, let's take a look here. I'm going to go.
Now, this is...
how big are the squares?
10 feet. And, of course, this right here is a balcony.
Oh, actually, you know what? I'm going to grab my sword that's on the ground. So I probably can only get, like, what, here?
Okay, so you pick up your long sword and move down. Okay, cool. Yeah. All right. The captain swings once again toe-to-toe with Veslar Noloth. Let's move him here. Okay, he lunges forward with his cutlass, slashing Veslar's left ribs for 6 points of damage.
Yep.
He then retaliates after a quick cut, comes down once again, and catches Veslar on his left shoulder for 7 points of damage.
All right.
Veslar is being pressed quite heinously by Captain Flores.
Where are my ladies at? What are they doing? Just like hanging out?
Where are my ladies at?
Yeah, well, you're being pushed back. Here you go.
Okay. Oh, no. Dang it.
Let's roll for the enemies. 18, okay. Aria! You are now standing on a large pile of barrels.
Well, no. I guess I'm not standing. I was just right there. Okay, all right, well, I'm going to take the wheel and spin it really hard to the left.
Oh, okay.
Interesting.
Yeah.
All right. Everybody on board, including Piper and Veslar, make a dexterity
Sorry,
check.
Sorry, guys.
So, hey, no, it's not a terrible idea. Maybe. 50-50.
Dex or balance?
So you're going to basically be making a balance check.
Oh, fuck. My balance sucks.
So, balance checks for all concerned. Piper, I love it!
Crash.
Oh, she falls overboard, right? She falls overboard.
I'm not near the edge, thankfully. Or the right edge. Or which way are you turning?
Left.
Maybe.
Left, which means the momentum is going the other way. Okay, Piper, you do not fly over... but you do stumble and fall down these stairs.
Yay!
Taking only 1 point of damage.
Yay, thanks, Ari.
Because you're in a crumbled heap at the bottom. Okay, all of a sudden, everybody on board gets thrown hither. Veslar, you barely manage to stay on your feet. Unfortunately, Captain Awesome is used to these crazy ebb and flows of the ocean. Gets an attack of opportunity.
Ah, you Aria!
Luckily for you, he missed.
I was gonna say, man. That's great.
Alright, so the ship suddenly veers violently to the left. Now that was the one part of it.
Here's the
second
next part.
Do we lose our lunch, right?
No.
Oh. Oh, we're going to the left. We're crashing into that ship, right?
Yep, basically,
yeah.
All
Thanks,
of a sudden,
Aria.
There is a loud and heavy as the two ships smash into each other. Everybody make another balance check.
Now we can get on the ship.
Thanks, Ari.
Oh, my goodness.
Jesus.
What?
A one.
Nice.
I got a two.
Oh, Aria.
Oh, God.
Aria, man.
Wow. No.
Okay, so...
I expected you to get 20.
Everybody's
guys.
Falling and flailing all over the deck. There's people being thrown to the left, thrown to the right.
That's awesome.
Let's just lodge a few people here. There we go. La la la. Okay. Well
did
done,
I land
Aria.
On wait, that's I landed hard. On someone.
What did you roll? Okay, you're on your ass, so you need to get up this turn.
I'm on a zero, so I don't know what happened.
You're
to
on your, yeah, you're basically laying like in this boat.
Oh, that's sweet.
Okay, that's Veslar, great. You need to get to your feet, good man.
Yeah, I got to my feet. I turned. I used the boat to, you know, stand up. Kind of like, oh.
Okay, you pull yourself to your feet. All right, it is now. Let me roll for them. Okay, it's neck and neck here on the ship. But for the most part, it looks like your sailors are winning. You have one, two, three sailors and their captain versus one, two sailors and their captain. You have a slight edge.
Well, not with Arya at the helm.
Whoa, what you doing there, captain? You just got
oh,
big.
Wow, he's large.
He cast enlargement.
You wouldn't like him when he's angry. My right. Ship.
Let's move people back into combat as they attempt to... Oh, actually, no, I forgot this guy. So, no, it's pretty much neck and neck. So I'm going to just move people into combat here. Line them up. There we go.
Line them up.
I was thinking that same thing. Get out of my head, woman.
I will.
Okay, so yes, we've got three sailors versus three pirates. The sailor's captain is over here. The pirate captain is here. And Veslar is somewhere lodged somewhere in the middle. Okay,
Veslar,
I'm
in the boat.
It's your turn.
Wait, you're in it's
a boat.
My turn.
I'm on a boat.
I thought it was my turn.
You crashed us.
You crashed the ship. That was your turn.
I'm
attacked. I thought your turn was getting up, Veslar.
Well, it is, pretty much. But then it would go to Piper, and her turn is getting up, right?
Yep.
Okay, captain's turn is getting up.
Okay.
Enemy's turn. Okay, no, Arya, yeah, you know what?
Yeah,
you are 100% right.
Okay,
it is your turn because everybody else is trying to get to their feet.
The captain is on the stairs now, yeah?
Yes. Well, he's actually he's at the bottom of the stairs after being stumbled.
So Arya's kicking down one of these barrels and trying to get it down the stairs to trip him again.
Alrighty. So you're going to like try to hurl one of the barrels down the stairs.
Yes.
Yes, you are.
Alright. Basically, you cut the rope.
It's time to do some bowling.
Captain bowling.
Oh,
okay,
yes.
Go ahead and make an improvised attack, which is basically minus four. So whatever your base attack plus strength, minus four.
Oh. Aw. Not even close.
Okay. You hurl one of the barrels, but it kind of bounces and comes to a rest right here. It doesn't really understand. It was a good idea, though. It was a good idea.
Take
all right,
that.
Veslar, you are on your feet.
I am attacking the guy with the orange.
Okay.
So he's wounded, so I'm just attacking
him. That's a Kuru. Thanks, thank
you. Although, the way my rolls have been going...
That's a Rook. Thank you for the follow.
21!
Antonio Morph, thank you for the follow. Okay, you lunge forward at this pirate and you strike.
And it's a four.
But not for much.
I'm still disoriented from the horrible ship.
That's
ship
clearly
sailing.
What it is. Yeah. Clearly disorientated from being thrown around when the two ships crashed into each other. All right. Piper.
Yes.
You are on your feet, but you're standing in a boat.
All right, well... It looks like this guy isn't that far, is he? Can I hit him from the boat?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Especially with a great
smashy,
sword.
Smashy, smashy,
and you get a plus two flanking bonus because if you see Veslar is right across from him, so...
See, that was my whole plan all along, is to see...
Right.
Is that what it was? Yeah.
The flanker, you know. The flank... Oh.
14.
A 14 is enough to hit.
Nice. What do we got? 2d6, nice. 2d6 plus. There's no damage for the flank increase,
no,
right?
That's just a hit.
Right. I need that. Nine.
Nine. Okay, you slash violently down with your two-handed sword, hacking straight through his upper collarbone, crashing him to the deck in one foul swoop. He is deceased.
Now,
Now,
I know cleave is used if people are enacted, but can I make a continued action as cleave, or
well,
is that
actually,
only to hit?
This guy right here is within cleave range.
Well, cleavey, cleavey, smash, smash. and please. He's not flanking, right?
Actually, no, because he's not.
No.
There's no one engaged with him, so no.
Yes.
But you don't need the flanking bonus with that roll. You hit
nice.
It.
Nice. Nice.
Smashy, smashy. 11.
For 11 points of damage. Okay. Taking the momentum of your first strike, you continue overhead and smash down into this guy, opening up a huge big gash in the his kind of like lower back ribs.
Ooh. Ouch.
As he winces in agony and pain. As he does so, this guy, realizing he's behind him, spins around, ready to face him. Okay, Captain X leaps over the boat, diving, charging,
oh,
basically,
God.
If you will, into Veslar.
Here comes the pain train.
Screaming,
do I hear him?
Bloody murder.
I hear him, okay.
Okay. Slashing down as he comes wildly swinging towards you. Unfortunately, you're not really facing him.
Yeah,
you
I know.
You're facing the other way. You feel the agony and pain in your left shoulder as he hacks you for 5 points of damage. You also then, out of the peripheral vision, see him lunge towards your lower rib cage, but somehow deftly manage to just throw your body to the right. Actually, that would be to your left. Get out of the way, Captain Asshole. Okay. And avoid the strike. But the pain is real. Enemies. Okay. Aria, as you stand up on the bow or the back of the ship with a large quantity of barrels, what do you want to do?
Muted.
Muted.
Oh, why was I muted? I sent you a message for a question about if I can do something.
Oh, okay. There you go. Yeah, they're fixed
okay.
mounted. They don't
gotcha.
They're not movable.
All right.
Good idea though.
So interesting. Okay, I'm gonna run down, and I'm guessing the ship is enough where I can just hop onto it now, right? The other
you
ship.
Can. You need to make a jump check with a difficulty of 12.
Wow.
It's a 12. Because the ships are still moving, neither one of them is anchored. There's about, you know, there's a lot of this
wow.
buoyancy stuff. It's not hard.
Yeah, but I'm going to fail anyway.
Do you want to do it?
Do it. Do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, let's try.
Oh, God. No.
Please don't fall
oh, boy.
In. This could be
oh,
ugly.
Yeah. Is there a rope anywhere? Yeah.
I mean, there's riggings and stuff. You can attempt
can
to
Can I jump
it
onto this instead and, like, crawl across?
Oh, no, that's a mast. That's, like, up in the air.
Oh. Well, there must be some ropes hanging about, right?
I mean, there's ropes where some of the people swung over, yeah.
Right, so I'll use
That's
those
why I'm
ropes
giving you a 12.
To help guide me. Frick. Yes!
There you
yes!
go! Okay, Aria grabbing hold of one of the ropes. Whee! Swings and lands on board.
Yeah, it's okay. It's not like we're in combat or anything.
Okay, you're on the Imperial vessel, the fleeing Mayweather. Okay, so that's your action. Now, the fleeing Mayweather does have ballistas on it.
Yeah.
That are pointing in this direction.
I know it.
I had a feeling that's what you were going for.
I really don't See? Like the idea of Arya with the ballista
we're
pointing
like,
at Piper
like
and me.
Like,
I just say that personally, you know? Just like.
Okay, now I've got to roll for them. Ooh, okay. Your sailor guys are not doing as well now.
Oh, no.
God damn it.
In fact, you are now, let's see, there are three pirates plus their captain versus one sailor and their captain. And, but then they have you on their side, so.
Oh boy.
Awkward. Awkward, when we all die, they lose. Okay, Veslar.
I'm going at the pot. I'm going at the captain.
You want to spin around and turn to face Captain Flores?
Yeah.
Pirate Captain Flores. Ahar. All right. Regular attack?
Yeah, 16.
Okay, you lunge forward at Captain Flores, but unfortunately, he pulls his ribs to the left and you cut his tunic, but it's not enough to hit him.
My tunic! No!
If I hit him power attack, that might have been
it. Imported silk!
Shit. Alright.
It was close, but not quite close enough. Alright. Piper!
Alrighty, I'm gonna take a swing at the guy right there, the orange guy.
Alright. You putting just a regular hit on it?
Yeah. Oh, fuck.
You lunge forward as you do so, stepping on one of the oars, you stumble a little bit and swing wildly and miss. It is now the captain's turn versus Veslar. Poor old Ves.
I know, yeah. I get picked on.
I have no heels, too. No.
He slashes low and wild at your leg, but you manage to pick it up and his blow swings beneath your foot. Oh. He then stabs, lunging forward. As he does so, you sidestep and parry the blow to your left. He missed. Enemies. 16. Okay. It is Arya's turn.
Where is this ballista?
Basically about right here.
Okay, and what are like the stats like to shoot a ballista?
It will be an improvised shot, so you do a ranged attack with a -4.
Ugh.
But if it hits, it's 3d8.
Wow. Okay, so...
And Captain Flores is pretty damn close to being in line with the ballista. The ballistas have got about a 60-degree turn. So you can either hit Flores, Veslar, if you'd like.
If I like. But if I miss, is there a chance it's going to hit one of my friends? Really?
No, that's why you get the -4.
Thank
goodness.
Because
you're firing into melee.
All right. Step up to
at least it's not all on
plate.
Fire yet, unlike last time.
Get ready to bat.
Oh, here we go.
Aria with the ballista.
Get that 9!
Oh. Okay, suddenly you got basically Veslar and Piper because you're both sort of... Suddenly a massive ballista bolt comes flying like between Veslar and Captain Flores, like right through the center. As you're both like, as this huge, big, giant chunk of wood that looks like somebody basically just shot a railway sleeper that was pointed at you, went, cruised and went straight through the other side. It takes 4 rounds to reload one of those, so you need to move up to the next one rather than try to reload that, unless you want to try to reload it. Good try, though. I hate it when awesome plans don't work.
It's all right.
Okay, let me roll for the pirates. Okay. Well, your pirates are... not the pirates, these guys. All of the sailors are pretty much down except for their captain, you guys. So it's not looking well. The situation is getting dire for your side. The pirates are winning. The sailors are getting hacked down. 2 of the sailors are pressing the enemy or the valiant captain from the running Mayweather or the fleeing Mayweather. And of course, it's down to Piper is engaging one of these guys, and Veslar is locked toe to toe with Captain Flores. All right, Veslar, it is your turn.
Just doing it, man.
Oh, yes!
19! I believe that is in your crit range, sir.
That is a crit, and with a power attack on top of it, so...
Let's see, do we... And it is a crit! It is a crit!
Oh, yeah.
Yes!
Alright, so let's... With the power attack, so basically you got your damage plus the power attack, and we're going to double it for you.
3, so plus 8. So that was all 5 points. Yep. Okay, here we go. Shibuti!
Oh! 17! 18 times 2!
Oh.
Damn.
Goodbye, Captain Fancy Pants.
Actually, hopefully, he's not dead. But he is seriously wounded. You lunge forward with your bastard sword, stabbing him right through the left side. It probably didn't hit any vitals, but suddenly he falls back and winces in agony, clutching his side as blood pours from his torso.
Nice. Sweet revenge.
Oh, do you for that?
Wait, what?
Okay, it is Piper's turn. She is right, toe-to-toe with one of the sailors.
Another
beautiful
swing
hit
at him.
Lovely.
Another swing. For 20.
Nice. Okay, your big, mighty, two-handed sword swings at the sailor.
For 10. 10
on top of what he's already received, the blow comes down in his right shoulder blade, splitting him from shoulder to torso as he collapses on the floor.
Yes.
All right, he is down. Captain versus Veslar. Okay, with his sheer agony and pain, he's not swinging twice. He just lunges violently forward once. However, the sheer agony that he is enduring is obviously playing, you know, into... he's struggling with his attack, so he, like, lunges forward, but it's very half-assed. You very quickly and easily parry it to the left. Knock his cutlass aside, almost like it was a kid with a wooden sword. Okay, there are no enemies left. Okay, the captain from the other side dispatches the last of the pirates.
Well, there's one more.
Isn't that the captain?
There's
one left alive right here. Okay, yeah. So he's gonna go. The captain's gonna take him up, unless somebody else gets involved. Okay, Aria.
Well, I'll run to the other ballista. Oh boy.
Let's see.
I can't really aim at that one because the captain's in the way.
That's as far as you can get. So you can't hit anybody. You can hit Piper.
I could hit. Oh, sure. I'd love to.
That's the only person
okay
you can hit from that.
Well,
ballista.
Instead of doing that, can I just start preparing the way for them to hop over quickly? So I don't know. Start tying some ropes together.
You
that's
can do that.
Easier
yep
than getting a 12. You know, yep. I'll
you
start that over
that
here.
Alrighty. Right, this sailor lashes out and slashes at their captain, catching him on the ribs, but he's still alive. Veslar, it is your turn.
Just doing a regular attack, nothing special.
Okay, attempting to finish him off, huh?
Pretty much. Trying to at least ensure a hit. Because, you know, 19.
That'll do it. You need to do 9 or more points of damage to finish off
Ooh
the captain. 9 or more.
He's a tough son of a bitch. Nope, that's not happening. Well, there's 4.
Okay, you lunge forward and slash him on his right thigh, but he's still alive. Piper, in the boat.
Yes, all right. Can I charge
that's
and
that's great,
attack?
Gaz. Thanks for the follow. You can charge him, yeah. From there. Gives you +2 to hit. Ah!
+2 to hit.
Oh!
Yeah, that'll work.
Natural 20!
Oh, I'm gonna hit him like he's never been hit before. Alright, this is for a potential crit. For 18.
And woo! It is a crit.
Bye bye, biatch.
There you go. Have a 1 on the roll. 1 on the 20 panel.
Yeah, so this is still just 2d6
plus
4?
2d6 plus 4 times 2!
20 points!
20 points! Okay, leaping over the corpses of the pirates.
Do I hear... Can I duck?
Yeah, it's like in slow motion, you basically see like the red hair of Piper like... Ah! Come flying over as she catches him right below the chin as his head flies clean off of his shoulders and bounces right here against the side of the ship and rolls across the ground. Epic.
Nice.
All of the enemy pirates are deceased.
What about this guy?
Oh, he just got killed by the other captain. Okay, who then charges valiantly towards you guys.
I'm going to immediately... Do I hear him coming? I mean...
Oh, yeah, you can basically see him, like...
I'm dropping my weapons, holding my hand up.
Okay.
Hold on.
All right, he points his sword right at your throat. He says, "Yield, sir!"
What weapons on the ground?
You're under arrest for piracy!
And I'm going to say immediately, can I yell?
Oh, by all means.
Do you not fight with your eyes open?
He kind of glances around and looks. He says, "With all the pirate scum and villainy, I only had time to pay attention to those wearing the king's uniform. You clearly do not. Who are you, woman?" He's still pointing the sword at Veslar, by the way.
Damn it. I put my hand up.
I'm going to say, we were on a vessel called the... What is it called? The...
Juliana's Pride.
Juliana's Pride, where we became shipwrecked and marooned. We came across this ship, and they told us they were traveling merchants and good folk, and we did not find out until they raised our pirate flag against you that they were indeed pirates, and we have fought this entire battle on your side, if you would have been paying attention, good sir.
Well, he kind of walks over and pokes the captain. He says, "This doesn't look like cutlass work. You there." And he kind of points and pokes you in the chest with the point of his sword again.
Ow.
Okay, at that point, he kind of starts poking you and puts his sword underneath the tip of your bastard sword and, like, raises it up. He says, This looks more appropriate. It seems like you could possibly be telling the truth. You sure you're not just pirate scum trying to save your worthless lives? No, I don't think so. You don't seem the sort.
Put my hands down.
Okay, at that point he pulls the sword away and sheaths it.
I pick up my weapons and sheath them too.
He says, "This has been a costly and bloody battle. But one more pirate of the open seas has been put to rest."
And likely so. Or rightly so, rather.
He says, "Have you made any stock of their provisions? Are you aware of any of their stolen wares? Any cargo that they may have taken?"
I'm going to take my sword, sheathe it, and say, "Honestly, good Captain..."
"I am Captain Durant."
"Captain Durant."
"Of the fleeing Mayweather."
"As I said... We only learned of their piracy moments before engaging your ship. And up until that moment, we thought we were on an honest merchant caravan and never bothered to check."
"I see. Well, normally I don't go toe-to-toe with an opponent. Usually I try to dance around a lot and shoot from a distance. But this time it just felt appropriate that we should get stuck in there." He said, "I'm glad you are on the inside working for the king."
"Always, sir."
"Well... Let's make inventory of what they have and carry as much of it as we can aboard the fleeing Mayweather, and then let's sink this vessel before it should fall in the hands of other unpleasant folk."
Can I could do that.
You can, yes.
"Say, Captain, I have prepared a way for entrance."
He kind of looks and he says, "You there, girl, what are you doing aboard my vessel?" Zethan Snerdly, thanks for the follow.
"That is my sister. She is quite lovely. I think you will find her most entertaining."
"Ha. Well, anybody that fights on the side of the king and against piracy is okay in my book. Well, come along. Let's hurry up and get these provisions aboard. Unfortunately, we have a bit of a problem. Most of my sailors have been dispatched in this unfortunate battle. Do any of you know how to man the rigging?"
Unfortunately, we do not. However,
well,
under your
command...
Well,
you're going to learn then, aren't you?
We will. Yes, sir.
All right, let's get to work. Basically, he goes downstairs. He starts looking at all the different inventory. And other than the silk and the textiles, he doesn't give a crap. Those he manhandles aboard. The rest of it doesn't care.
I'm gonna take some bottles of like water, the barrels of water we did, just in case.
Okay. And there's all. I mean, there's barrel. As you know, there's barrels of wine. There's bottles of sparkling wine.
Yep, doing it all. That's what I'm doing.
Okay.
Even it over.
Alrighty.
As Piper climbs over and you say, "I shot a ballista today."
Did you, Ari? Well done.
And then I'm gonna go on underneath and set a bunch of little tiny fires. I'm gonna burn it down from the inside.
Alrighty. See, did I move everybody over? I did. Alright. Well, I mean, there are still some people on board this vessel. They're not combative sailors, they're cooks, a sawbones, a couple of cabin boys, and a few elderly looking folk, but there are enough people to man the ship as long as you help. He says, "Well, I appreciate your efforts, and I'm more than happy to take you to your port of call. Where would you like to be taken?"
What Villatorian guy?
Aria?
I have it in my notebook at home.
Excuse me?
Where are we going?
Where are
we're going?
We're
going to Erasmus, right?
I need to get Gypsy, yes.
Yes, back to the mainland.
No.
where? What was the town name that we left from?
Yeah, maybe do like a bardic knowledge or something.
The Sea Town.
Sea Town.
Oh, with that's the giant. Not narrowing it down with the giant. Oh.
I shall use my bardic knowledge to try to remember the name of the town.
Okay. Because it's painful and agonizing to watch.
I would have it, but
you remember it was called Shoreford Bay.
Shoreford, that's the one. Yes.
Yes.
The bay one, the one with the bay in it. Yeah.
The shore, yeah.
All right, he says, "No problem, we will be there in less than 2 weeks.
Oh, okay, thank you, sir.
God, you people.
We're going to Creek's Hollow, man. Take us there.
Creek's Hollow? Yeah, that's a little inland. All right, so basically aboard the fleeing Mayweather under the command of Captain Durant, you make your way to the mainland, and after about just over two weeks, you arrive.
Are we healed in 2 weeks?
Shoreford Bay.
Well, Arya better have healed us. I mean, that would just be
We're healed.
For the sake of 2 weeks, I'm not going to make you roll. I'm going to assume after 2 weeks, you could totally have healed everybody. Including Captain Durant.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Once you arrive there, Captain Durant bids you farewell, lets you off on the dock. He says, may I take your names?
I imagine you would have taken our names before.
Probably, but
we left him for 2 weeks. We're just like that dude.
Well,
he knows.
He knows your first names. He wants your last names.
And
as well.
Veslar Nala.
All right. He writes it down. He says, "I will be sure to mention your good services to the admiral." And well, I suppose it would be not too unfitting if I was to bestow upon you, as I am a honor-abiding...
Are you marrying us?
No.
Sorry.
I was actually going to tell you that there is a 300 gold crown reward for the capture of any pirate, or the killing of any pirate, and as it was, in fact, your sword that took down Captain Flores and not mine, I feel it is only appropriate to hand you this letter of mark. Present this to any of the king's agents, and he will reward you for 300 gold crowns.
Fantastic.
So write that down as a piece of treasure, if you will.
I'm just going to look
Stealing
at
Stealing Souls and Crankshaft. Thanks for the follow, guys.
So that would be...
Thank God, right?
He's giving it to me, because it was my sword.
Yep,
that
basically, it's a 300 gold crown letter of mark, which means it's worthless unless you hand it in to someone that can cash it. But upon doing so, it's worth 300 gold crowns. They'll pay you for it.
Awesome.
Are you sure you're not marrying us? Yes, you are all collectively married now.
As
me
we
too.
Leave, As we leave the captain, I would like to just quickly look at him and put the hand over the heart and say, may your sword be sharp as I go.
And to you.
I follow Piper's example, but I just say,
something about witches.
I just bow and say, have a lovely afternoon.
Alrighty, so as you debark back to the familiar town of Shoreford Bay.
My horse!
Yeah, actually, your horse and the wagon is both, in fact, at this, if it's still here.
Better be.
Let's go find out. We gotta go to Erasmus, guys.
Yeah, make haste.
On the lay, everybody.
Yeah. Them sounds.
Debark.
All right.
Yeah.
Debark. Debark said, plus disembark. Debark, right?
Debark, yeah. Makes sense.
Debark. Okay, so let's see. It is mid-afternoon when you arrive at this town.
So we'll probably head straight for the warehouse to check on the horse.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really concerned about Gypsy, so that would be kind of my first thing.
Okie dokie. Upon arriving there, your wagon plus two horses and Gypsy are fine. They have been well taken care of.
Excellent.
Of course, the young man there, he says, I can't release them to you, though.
Until payment is made, I assume?
Yes, you have to bring me the appropriate docket. Which you can acquire from the tavern. But I've taken good care of him. He said, you've been gone a long while, so I noticed how diligently she was taken care of before, so I've bathed her every other day and groomed her frequently.
And your name?
Oh, Donovan, miss. Donovan.
Thank you. I'm just gonna turn and I'm going to get my letter.
Okay.
For release.
Alright, so you wander into the old Sea Dog Tavern.
Sirens for days. After my quick appraisal of Gypsy, she does look well taken care of and everything.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, cool.
Alrighty, you make your way back inside the old Sea Dog. And the innkeeper, or barkeep, is over here.
Alright, so I'm going to go... Arya
is going straight for the young boys.
Isn't that the same guy who was hitting on her earlier?
Oh, he tried to, and she totally dismissed him. Like, crashed and burned in the worst possible way.
No, I threatened to kill him, but...
You're right.
So I'm going to go to the barkeep, order some food, and pay for Gypsy.
I hate to do this, but because we got distracted with the whole disconnect, we forgot our donation.
Oh boy.
And I just realized, and I hate that, so we're going to stop right now and thank AngelGirl86 for her kind donation that said, I've been having a rough time and looking forward to watching all weekend. You brighten my darker days. Girl,
thank you.
I hope you're still here. I hope we didn't lose her between now and... Are you still here?
Nice.
She is still here. Okay, good.
That's very sweet.
Girl.
And also, chat that the sirens were not in my place, just so you guys know.
They were coming.
Everyone's like, there's the New York cops are coming.
So, Angel Girl, like, thank you so much for the donation. We're glad we could help. You know, feel free to, you know, message us if you want to chat, whatever. Epic, thank you so much. Okay, back to it. Sorry, I missed it.
And no,
I,
hey,
I
no,
felt
that's
bad
fair.
For doing so. So
that's fair. So yes, I wanted to pay for the boarding, order some food, and I'm also going to comment about the boy taking good care of my horse.
Okay.
Taking exceptional care of my horse.
All right. He says, "Well, let me tally up. Let's see, one wagon, two horses, plus one horse. Food, board, by my account, you owe me 12 gold and 6 silver pieces, miss.
And that's with dinner?
Oh, no, I was just talking about the horses. You want board for how many?
Three.
All right.
Two rooms, three people.
Then 13 gold, 2 silver pieces should more than cover it. Thank
should
you.
More. 13 gold, 2 silver?
Yes, please, miss.
Okay. Pay up.
Alrighty.
Alright, so I'm assuming we're going to eat.
Yes. Where would you like to sit?
There are no free tables.
Would you may need to make one.
I'll make my way over then. Excuse me.
Oh, hello. What can I do for you?
You mind if we sit here? Me and my friends?
I was just finishing, actually. I'll be, you're a quite pretty little thing, aren't you? Haven't
yeah,
seen
she's
you around
gorgeous.
Here before.
Yeah, she's beautiful. Hurry up and eat.
Oh,
Pip, I was making conversation.
As all of you immediately, like, surround the table, he's suddenly like, yes, well, as I said, I was just leaving. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Goodbye, kind sir or madame.
As he makes his way out of the door, as you vacate the table.
I immediately take a spot. Back to the wall.
Your seat is quite warm.
Ooh.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Pip, did you order us food?
I did. And I got you some wine, Ari.
Veslar, thanks. Ari, and Piper, make a listen check, if you will. However, you will need a 16 or higher.
I hear nothing.
That's not
nothing.
19.
Hey-o. Nope.
Okay. Get Aria, of course, especially as she's closest to. The two sitting behind you, fairly well-dressed individuals, you hear... Aria, you overhear...
Well, if he is one, he would be interested, but I really don't want to get involved in such things. But it is our hometown, after all. We probably should mention it. No, no, woman. Be quiet. There's nothing to be gained by idle gossip with his type. You know how they are. They'll probably hang the local midwife and execute the local herbalist as soon as look at the local townfolk. Yes, but how do you explain the missing corpses? Something clearly is very wrong. Shh, woman. They may overhear us.
Excuse me. I'll be back.
Okay, Ari. Be careful.
Okay. I'm going to carry my drink with me and walk this way and then accidentally trip, spill my drink a little bit on her dress.
Okay.
And I go, oh, I'm so sorry. Excuse me, madame. Excuse me. Oh, what a pretty dress you have.
She says, it was quite pretty.
Yes. Let me go get something to wipe up. I'll be right back.
No, it's quite all right.
Oh, I went anyway to grab a towel.
I saw that.
Or
you fled across the room floor so fast.
And I come back and I start mopping it up. I am so sorry. This is fine material. Where did you get this?
Oh, imported silk.
Imported? From where?
Oh, I really don't know. I just wear it. I know it looks nice, though.
Yes. Yeah, I just got done dealing with some imports out in the sea myself. It's been quite the adventure.
Oh, really?
Yes. Well, fascinating.
So, where do you hail from? Where did you travel here to Shawford Bay? Do you come from an exotic, far-off land?
I do. So far, in fact, you've probably never heard of it.
You sound quite proverbially common to me. That dialect sounds rather local.
Well, I am quite good with languages.
She says, oh, come now, husband. We should broaden our horizons. He said, yes, we should broaden our horizons, but perhaps more than 2 leagues from here.
Well, let me tell you, you should go out and travel, because I've seen amazing things. In fact, we just got shipwrecked, and we fought giant crabs, sharks, snake men.
Being shipwrecked stuff. And having crabs is no idea of mine of a good time, ma'am.
Well, to each their own. Do you guys have any fascinating stories?
Not really, no.
Who says that?
Come on, I want to hear of exotic tales from this land.
Well, of this land, I don't really know any exotic tales. This
you
is
two
a fairly mundane,
only...
mundane area, you know, nothing much
you
happens here.
You two may be the only two people I meet in this town. Do you want me to leave, thinking that this is a boring place?
Personally, I don't care if you do or don't. There's other people here. That fellow over there, he points at this big, oafish-looking guy at the bar. Says, he looks rather interesting. Why don't you go bother him some?
Bother? Am I bothering you guys? I'm going to sit down.
Well, you did just spill your drink on my good lady wife here, and you've chosen to make yourself at home at our table.
Yes, I do owe you a new dress, don't I?
Well, I wouldn't go as far as to say you owe me a new dress. I mean,
I'm happy to provide.
Oh, no, we're quite wealthy. We don't need your charity. Just maybe perhaps be more careful next time.
I'll do my best to be careful. My name's Arya, by the way.
Oh, yes, well, it's a pleasure to meet you, my dear.
You too.
I am Lord, and this is Lady Henfield.
Lord and Lady Henfield, pleasure. So.
Yes, I am Harry Henfield. And this is Waynetta.
This is what?
Waynetta.
Waynetta and
Henfield, yes.
Beautiful names. Gorgeous. Are you standing behind me, Vessler?
I'm going to look over at Piper, give a great big smile, take my drink, and just go like this over Arya's head.
So you dumping? Are you dumping?
I'm dumping my drink over Arya's head.
What?
And then going,
what?
I'm sorry. Let me get that for you. And I'm coming over here getting some napkins. And then coming back and just tossing them at her.
Brothers, right?
And then I just
look at Henry.
And I'm going to sit back to Piper and just give her a big smile.
Why did you do that?
She had it coming. The bolts, man. You remember the ballista bolts? It was like this close to me. I wanted to do that ever since we were back on the ship. I'm
she
sorry.
Information,
well,
idiot.
I think that is an appropriate time to allow Jagger and Bane to take a quick break.